When it comes to logo design, one of the most crucial parts of the process is presenting the logo, either to a client or team members. Once you have put all the work into designing, developing, and finalizing the work, the next challenge is convincing a client or team of its merits and that your design is what they should use for their product, company, or business. Up to this point on the course, I have shown you a process to design your logos from scratch. I have shown you how to prepare in-situ visuals to showcase your design in the right context, and I have shown you how to prepare a logo client proposal document, which you can use to sell your design to your client or team members. When you have finally put together the proposal document, it is now time to arrange a time to present your work. Now, this can be quite a challenge. You have put a lot of work into a design you believe is great and right for the project, and now you have to convince someone else. A good presentation can make or break the success of your design. So in this video, I'm going to discuss 10 tips you can keep in mind to help you through it. So let's get into it. So here I am with my design process checklist. Once we have created a logo proposal document and we have checked each task, we can now move into step 3 in phase 4. So the third step in the present logo designs phase is present to team members or the client. So when presenting your design work, 10 tips you can consider when presenting a logo design to a client are: why present, when to present, how to present, print or digital, order of speak, does it work, take on board criticism, have a conversation, aim to agree and focus on an outcome, and make notes of feedback. So the first point is, why present? Now, some of you may be wondering, do I really need to present to the client? Can I not just send some images over? Well, this is the difference between a logo you get on Fiverr and a logo design you pay a professional thousands of pounds for. Quick and cheap logos normally only focus on the end result, because after all, they are cheap and there is typically no time allocated. Remember, when you're selling design, you're not just selling the end result, you're selling your design process. Of course, it's the end result which the client ultimately wants and thinks they are paying for, but it's your experience and reputation which they are getting, which ultimately leads to a really good end result for them. It's what sets the amateurs apart from the pros. This is why companies are prepared to pay over £100,000 plus to reputable design agencies over new design graduates. It's like anything, the more quality that goes into something, the more expensive the cost. Presenting to a client using a proposal document demonstrates a deep process of thought, understanding, strategy, and a professional design approach tailored exactly to the client. This makes a good impression, reflects well on your credibility, and adds value to your design work. Clients have always responded well to carefully presented proposal presentations, which has worked really well to sell my design. So next, you want to keep in mind, when to present. So when working on a logo design project, as well as factoring in the time it's going to take you to design and develop the logo, you will also need some time to put together a proposal document. Now, this should be factored in and agreed on right at the start before you start the design process. Now, a client may insist this is not necessary, but you really should insist that it is important, an important part of the process and part of the product they are paying for, because it's an opportunity for you and the client to discuss and reflect on the design. This is really important for both you as a designer and the client to get the best out of the design process and the product they are paying for. Also, there may be details and specifics you will want to demonstrate and talk through with the client. So you want to aim to present only once you are satisfied you have put together an adequate proposal document. So next, you will also want to keep in mind how to present. Now, when presenting a logo, I would never recommend sending flat JPEGs or a PDF over an email and waiting for the client to give feedback. Now, I call this showing cold, where you just show the work without any buildup and without any journey or explanation. Whomever sees the logo straight off the bat may not respond well, may be underwhelmed and start to find fault. Also, you really can't control how the client sees the design. They may skip to the end and miss important details. In my experience, the best results are when you can present your work to the client in order and take them on a journey through some process. If you can take the audience on a journey and tell a story, this can really engage and excite them, which will really help sell your design ideas. Now, it really helps to show what has gone into the design and then reveal the logo after in context, as it will be much more clear. Only when you've presented the document to the client should you then send a PDF afterwards for them to take a closer look in their own time. Another thing to keep in mind is print or digital. When presenting your design, it will help to keep in mind how you're going to present to your audience. In my experience, I have often presented in print, where I have printed out each page and pinned it up on a wall, where multiple people can stand back and talk through it. In this case, I may compose my presentation in a format that is easily printed on individual pages. However, this is not always possible. Sometimes you may need to present over a conference call if you cannot be present with a client or have any space for a project wall. In this case, I may compose my presentation in a format that is easily presented on slides, on screen, and can be exported easily as a PDF. I always seek to find out the circumstance early on in the process so I can prepare for this. Another thing you want to keep in mind is order of speak. Now, sometimes when presenting, the audience can pick out details and start focusing on things and ask questions which are often answered during the course of the presentation. Ideally, you don't want to be talking over people, answering lots of questions and explaining yourself throughout the presentation. This can be distracting, impact on your flow, and it can also delay the time allocated to present. When presenting, you want to take control. Remember, it's your design and you need the opportunity to present it clearly. Now, personally, when presenting design for the first time, I like to present everything first, so the audience has a good overview and grasp of everything, and then give lots of time to take questions, feedback, and discussion afterwards. So at the start of every presentation, I will say something like, "Welcome everyone, glad to be presenting my work to you today. Here I have some design for you that I feel really tackles the goals of the brief and delivers a really good creative solution, which I'm really excited to share with you. So I'm going to take you through the presentation. It will only take about 10 minutes, and I'm sure there will be lots of questions along the way, so please make a note of them so we can discuss them and any feedback at the end. Thank you." So this helps set a precedent straight away, asking people to allow me to present first. If you can aim to speak and present everything first and then allow all feedback afterwards, that generally works really well. It allows everything to flow and gives you space to present your work. Now, there will always be someone who asks a question while you present, which of course is okay. Though remember, if it starts to get out of hand, just politely remind them, "Please make a note of any questions and we can discuss them after the entire presentation is complete. Thank you." Another thing to keep in mind is, does it work? So when getting feedback from a client, you want to avoid feedback based on subjective opinions and feelings. When presenting your design, avoid asking the client if they like it. Also, avoid asking the client what they think about the design. So don't ask the client if they like it and don't ask what they think. This will only encourage responses based on personal tastes. Remember, 1,000 people may like your design and 1,000 people may not. It's arbitrary. Instead, ask the client, "Do you think it works?" Now, you want to encourage the client to focus on if the solution works rather than if they like it. Now, a client may respond really well and say they love it or they like it, and that's great feedback and a good sign. However, they could just as easily reply with, "I don't like it." Ideally, you want to get the client to agree that the design works, because that is what you are looking to achieve. If you can get the client to agree on a design that works, then that will help bypass any personal tastes and increase the chances of getting it approved and signed off. Another thing to keep in mind is, take on board criticism. When it comes to design, you can never guarantee that someone is going to see it from your point of view. There will always be times where some people just don't like your design or have other ideas to add. So always be ready for criticism and challenging feedback. So after you have presented your work, you should be ready to answer any questions and discuss feedback. And sometimes you may encounter criticism or negative and challenging comments. Now, when it comes to criticism, I always keep these three things in mind. Have a positive attitude. If you do get challenging comments, try not to get defensive about your work initially. You will always have time to respond and discuss. So whatever criticism comes your way, just take it on board and at least show you have considered it. It helps to be positive, even if you have to pretend. Be open to hearing other people's thoughts on your design. Now, being welcoming and collaborative works really well and shows that you are willing to take on board the opinions of others and work as a team. It may be your design, but sometimes people do have good ideas too. Always be open to hearing what people have to say, as they may be able to add something you have missed. Be ready to counter criticism. Now, more often than not, unless you have made a big mistake, criticism can simply be subjective. As mentioned earlier, try and keep feedback based on what works in response to the goals rather than likes and dislikes. So make sure the criticism is objective, not subjective. When you undertake design work, you should always aim not to make arbitrary decisions. Remember, good reasons always trump subjective and personal tastes. If your design works, then it doesn't matter what anyone feels about it. Remember, design is not art. When it comes to design, likes and dislikes are irrelevant. What matters is if the design works well or not in response to the goals of the brief. Sometimes a design will work and be appropriate, but may not be to everyone's tastes. If anyone challenges you on superficial elements of your design, just be ready to challenge the design reasons you chose and why you feel it works for the design. If you can give a good argument why something works, it's hard for someone to argue simply because they don't like it. So if you find yourself in a situation where people are not liking your design, be ready to counter with good reasons and rationale, and try and encourage them to focus on if it works rather than focus on superficial things, which can always be worked out later. Another thing to keep in mind is, have a conversation. Now, it's really important at the start of the presentation to be heard initially, but once you have covered everything, it's good to encourage conversation. After you have shown the work, always ask the client or audience if they think the design or designs work and meet the goals of the brief. Then listen carefully to their response. Inevitably, there are going to be lots of questions and feedback, and there may even be criticism. Take this valuable time to listen to the client, discuss any feedback, and respond to any challenging questions and criticism. Try and get as much out of the audience as possible, as this is an important time to learn and rule out weaknesses. In my experience, talking through the work has highlighted things I may have missed and added some interesting new ideas to enhance the overall design. This ultimately leads to a better end result. So one of the most important things to keep in mind is, aim to agree and focus on an outcome. Now, ultimately, after a proposal, you want to try and agree with the client on an outcome. The sole purpose of the proposal is to show your design and come away with a chosen logo design the client approves of. You don't just want to show it all and leave the client overwhelmed. Remember, you want to keep the client focused on an outcome. So after you have presented your proposal and answered any questions, the most important question you can ask is, can we agree on a logo you think works best for your product, company, or business? Now, if you're presenting one logo, then you will simply ask, do you agree this logo works for you? However, if you're presenting more than one design, you want to have a quick review on which one the client feels works best. As the presentation comes to a close, you want to encourage the client to choose an option which you can agree on, focus on, and finalize. Normally, a client will resonate with one in particular, and that makes things easy. However, there may be times where the client thinks they all work and cannot make a decision for themselves. In this case, you can argue the case for the design you think works the best and advise them on a decision. If you can agree on a design at the end of the proposal, then you are one step closer to meeting the goals of the brief and completing the project. So the last thing to keep in mind is, make notes of feedback. So at the end of the presentation, hopefully you will agree with the client on a chosen logo. However, during the Q&A and feedback session, chances are there will be a lot said and even some requests made. Now, these could be something you missed or something you could add. So always be ready to take notes. Either write them down on paper or type them out. This shows you are listening and you will be able to take appropriate action after the presentation. So those are 10 tips you can consider when presenting your logo design to a client or team. So with all that in mind, it's now time to put it into practice and present the logo proposal document to the client. In the next video, I'm going to showcase a demonstration on how I will present my logo design proposal document to a client. So see you in the next video.